This is First Friday Reboot. And so we're going to have a lot more praise and worship. We've got an exciting lineup for this year to invite voices that Jacksonville doesn't normally get to hear. And we're hoping that the city's going to come out and be encouraged and blessed and inspired. Hallelujah. Especially on Shabbat. I know it's a long day. Some of you even work. Do anybody have a job? Yeah, some of you actually have a real job and you work during the day and then run home and grab the kids if they're still in the house. Mine are, they're in their 30s, so I'm still grabbing my kids and head out to come and worship. But we want to invest in you. That's what First Friday is all about, investing in our community and let the Spirit of God really speak to us. His name is El Shaddai. His name is El Elyon. His name is Yeshua HaMashiach. His name is Adonai. Jesus as Lord, Yeshua HaMashiach, Hu Adonai. Join me in this ancient prayer if you know it. Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, let's sing this, declare this in English. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And blessed be his glorious name, whose kingdom is forever and forever and forever and forever and forever. And all the kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Messiah, and he shall reign forever and forever. Hallelujah. Come on, let's declare it again.
You are Lord over all the earth. You are Lord.
And every time they got together, it had to be a pressed white shirt, a brand new suit, and a Penn Colby tie. Remember Penn Colby ties?
Yes.
Me either. They were too expensive. And I love that in Florida, we're not really, you know, checking each other out. How much did you spend for those jeans? Or are flip-flops allowed? And, you know, we look on the outside, but God looks on the inner parts. And I'm really glad that we can get together and worship on Shabbat. Amen. All right, here's a new song. It's got a lot of Hebrew in it, but it's good for you because once you learn this, maybe you've heard me say this before, you don't have to go to Hebrew remedial school in heaven. You'll just be able to come and fly around the universe with the rest of us who learned the Hebrew here. So pay attention. This is Psalm 95, verses 1 and 2, and a couple of others, some of my favorites. Let's come and sing for joy to the Lord. Here we go, man. Actually, this is a good one to snap fingers on and say, drums. Actually,
We won't try to get that back. Monkey, if you find your spot, please. Actually, the scripture says, and we sang it, Panav. Nekadma Panav Betodah. Come before his face. Panav is face in Hebrew. Come before his face with thanksgiving. Lord, we delight to be in your face tonight. I pray that you'll press in on us. And may we know you face to face, even as it says of Moses, as a man speaks to his friend. Why don't you have a seat for just a moment tonight? And as is our custom, we will light the Sabbath candles. My wife is already accomplishing that. We light the candles on Shabbat, two of them. One representing creation, when he said, let there be light, and there was. And the other for the light of the world, Yeshua, Jesus. He is our Messiah. He is the light of the world. He's the way, the truth, and the life. And as is traditional, my daughter will speak the Hebrew and the English blessing over the candles.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kidshanu B'Mitzvotav V'Tzivanu Lahiyot Or Legoyim V'Natan Lanu Et Yeshua Mashicheinu Or Haolam. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who has sanctified us with his word, commanded us to be a light unto the nations, and who gave us Yeshua, our Messiah, the light of the world.
Amen. And on our table, Sabbath table, we have two more elements. We have a cup. If you're Baptist, you don't want to know what's in there. And we have bread. It's an unusual looking loaf. Most loaves are nice and round. This one is braided. And why is it braided? There's three strands that are woven together to resemble the crossing of our arms in rest, because the Lord declared, in 6 days you shall do all of your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath of rest unto me. And if you read your scriptures, you know that Yeshua is called the Lord of the Sabbath. And some would say, well, so Paul, that means that Sabbath is passed away. No, as we read our scriptures carefully, he's the Lord of the Sabbath. This is the perfect day to come before him, to rest, to honor him, to honor his presence, the work that he's done in our lives. And if you remember on the Mount of Beatitudes, he gave a great teaching, and he said, don't think that I came to abolish the law or the prophets, but I've come to fulfill them. That word fulfilled in the Greek is pleroo. It means raised to its highest expression. So he didn't wipe the Sabbath off, but what he did was raise it to its highest expression. It's the best day to come and to worship. And that's another reason that we love to gather on this Shabbat. And I hope before I leave the planet, or he comes to gather us all to himself, that the church worldwide will begin to embrace these celebrations of the Lord, the Lord's Passover, and Pentecost, the Feast of Weeks, and Tabernacles, and the Sabbath, because he gave these to us. These aren't requirements for us to fulfill. He gave us these feasts to celebrate him, and that we would have a great excuse to lay everything else aside, come together to rest, to enjoy. And he said, whenever you do this, do it in remembrance of me. So every Sabbath we take this cup, like Yeshua did every Shabbat, and especially on that Passover night, the third cup, the cup of redemption, the promise made to Moses long ago. He said, I will redeem you with an outstretched arm. And Yeshua, Jesus himself, said, this is that promise fulfilled. And we celebrate it and remember him every week. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri hagafen. Blessed art thou, Lord our God, King of the universe. You bring forth the fruit of the vine. And he took some bread, and he said, this bread resembles my body, which will soon be given for you. And do this in remembrance for me. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Blessed art thou, Lord our God, King. Bring forth bread out of the earth. Amen. And he said to those who were listening, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you who stone the prophets and kill those I send to you, how often I've wanted to gather children together as a hen gathers her chicks, but you were not willing. And you'll not see me again until you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Thank you.
Just how great come on, lift up and bring praise to the name of the Lord tonight. In the name of the Lord. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Hallelujah. Well, before you're seated, why don't you greet one or two folks that are around you? Don't go too far. And then you may be seated.